Now, the next topic that we'll be learning is moment of a force, a very important topic. Moment of a force about a point is the measure of rotational effect of the force. It is also defined as moment of a force about a point is defined as the product of the magnitude of the force and the perpendicular distance of the point from the line of action of the force. So it's a big definition. But this second one is more concise definition. We'll see what exactly moment of a force is. For example, let us say that this is a bolt or a screw and we have to tighten it using the spanner. Okay, so I will apply a force here. What will happen here at this point? It is going to rotate, is it not? So, but I had applied a translational force. I had applied a simple force. Then how did it rotate? So we can say that the force is able to cause a rotational effect also if it is being acted at a certain distance from that force. So this is nothing but your moment. The rotational effect of a force is called as your moment. And how much that effect is, that is what your value of the moment, right? So we are considering the moment acting at this point A, and how we have to calculate this moment is, this is the line of action of our force. See, according to definition, it is the product of magnitude of the force. This is the magnitude of the force and the perpendicular distance of the point. This is the point from the line of action of the force. Two things very important here: perpendicular distance from the line of action. So this is my line of action, correct? The perpendicular distance is this. So basically, if I draw a line, it has to be perpendicular to my line of action. So the distance perpendicular to line of action till the point, that is the distance that I have to multiply with my force to get this moment, to get the value of that moment. So moment about a point A due to force F is ma is equal to f into d, correct? According to this definition, moment is force into the perpendicular distance. Units of moments are, see, this is force is newton, units of distance, d is distance basically, so it can be meter, millimeter, anything. Force can also be newton, kilonewton. Okay, we are following the SI units, so in that it is newtons, kilonewtons. So the units can be newton meter, kilonewton meter, newton mm, kilonewton mm, depending on how, which units you are following for the force and the distance. The point about which the moment is taken, that point is called as moment center. Okay, and the distance, the perpendicular distance from line of action to the moment center is called as moment arm. This is called as moment arm, or it is also called as lever arm. But more technical term is moment arm. Now, accordingly, as we have sign conventions for the forces, we do have sign convention for moments also. So its sign convention is pretty easy. Let us say that this is the axis of rotation, correct? This is the axis of the rotation. If I point my thumb outwards to the axis of this rotation, and a right hand thumb, and then if I curl my fingers, then the curl of the finger is going to represent the positive moment. Okay, so here it is anti-clockwise. The curl of the fingers of right hand with thumb facing in the direction of axis of rotation will give positive moment direction. For 2D problems, we may consider anti-clockwise moment to be positive. For all 2D cases that we'll be solving, we are going to consider anti-clockwise moment to be positive and consecutively clockwise moment to be negative. This is a clockwise moment. See, clockwise means something that is basically moving in the direction of how a clock works. We all understand, right? So this is a clockwise moment. and opposite to that would be an anticlockwise movement. So therefore, in this case, the moment value is minus F into D. If we follow the sign convention, moment value is minus F into D. Okay. So now this sign convention that I was writing all this time, I will modify this sign convention a little bit, and instead of writing all these negative and everything, I will just write the positive sign convention. So now I will be only writing this positive force values, that is in the right direction it is positive, upward direction it is positive, and for moment the anticlockwise moment is positive. So this will be now a new symbol for sign convention. The negative is understood from this itself, that opposite of this is obviously going to be negative. Let us consider a few cases. Find moment at point A due to force F. So we have this rod kind of thing and a force is acting at an angle of theta. I need to find the moment at A. I can resolve this force into two components. It's a horizontal as well as vertical component. You can see that by definition of moment, it is basically the perpendicular distance between the point about which we are finding moment and the line of action. So for this inclined force, the line of action is like this. Correct? Even if I extend it here downwards, this is going to be the line of action. The perpendicular distance from this line of action is basically this distance, which is a little bit difficult to find. Therefore, the easiest way to do is that we resolve this force into its horizontal and vertical component. So if we resolve, we get Fx is equal to F cos theta and Fy is F sin theta. We have resolved this force into its horizontal and vertical component. Now what we can understand from this is, see, for Fy the line of action is this and the distance perpendicular from point A is, let us say, D till this line of action of Fy. And what is the line of distance perpendicular from F of X? Fx line of action. If this is the line of action of Fx, then the distance is zero basically. Okay. So MA due to Fy, you can see this Fy is going to cause a clockwise moment about A. The way how we need to understand how a force is going to cause moment is that you fix or you pin this point, okay, you put a pin here and you think that this point is going to stay where it is and this F is going to rotate about that point. So let this point be the center and F be the force that is rotating about that center. So you need to understand how that rotation is going to act, whether it will be a clockwise rotation, whether it will be an anticlockwise rotation. So here you can see clearly it is a clockwise rotation. Therefore, this moment is a negative moment, minus Fy into D, and because of this Fx, it is 0, Fx into 0, because there is no perpendicular distance between the line of action for Fx and A. Right? I hope you are understanding this. Therefore, if the point about which the moment is to be taken lies along the line of action of a force, then moment due to that force is zero. A very, very important statement to remember, that if the point is lying along the line of action of that force, it is going to be zero. Okay. If I had considered a force like this, let us say, if this was one of the force, what would be the moment because of this force? If I draw the line of action of this force, you don't even have to resolve it, because directly you can say that this point of moment, or this moment center, what we call, that is lying along the line of action of this force. Therefore, that moment definitely has to be zero. Even if you resolve it and see, you will get it as zero itself. Let us check one more example here. Find moment at point A and B due to force of 10 newtons. So we have this frame type of thing, and there is a 10 newton force which is acting this way downwards. It is acting, the distance between AB is 5 meters and from B to this point is 4 meters. This is the line of action for 10 newton, and for finding moment we need to understand what is the perpendicular distance from that moment center. So let us say that I am considering A first. This is the moment center and I need to find the perpendicular distance from the line of action till that moment center. And basically also you have to consider the sign, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. So you can see, if I fix this point and if this force rotates, keeping this as center, if this force rotates along about that point, we can see that it is rotating in a clockwise manner, correct? So in this case it is negative, therefore it is minus 10 into 5 plus 4, which is equal to minus 90 newton meters. Okay, minus 90 newton meters. In brackets you can write it as clockwise. At B, the perpendicular distance from its line of action is 4 meters. So 10 into 4, that is also negative, because if I consider, if I pin this point and I try to rotate this 10 keeping B as center, it again goes clockwise, therefore it is negative. Minus 10 into 4, which is minus 40 newton meters. Again, that is clockwise. Let us see this example. Find moment at point A and B due to force of 10 newtons. So we have this force of 10 newton which is acting at a slope of 1:3. And we have this distance of 9 meters and here it is 3 meters. Theta for this force, because obviously this is inclined force, let us resolve it into its horizontal and vertical component, because that is, yeah, that will be easier for us to calculate with the distances and all. So theta is tan inverse of 1 by 3, which is 18.4349 degrees. Let me calculate it first about let us first calculate its horizontal component and vertical component. So this is the horizontal component, this is vertical component, this is your angle theta. So fx is 10 cos of 18.4349, which is 9.4868. and please remember that when you are showing your forces diagrammatically, see, there are two ways how we can represent forces. One is you show the force in a diagram, or one is you write the force in an equation. Okay, you write the value of the force in an equation. When you show it in diagram, if you are showing the arrows of the force, never to mention the sign of that force, okay, because you are already showing the arrow of a force. For example, if my force is like this, if I have these two components of 10 and 10, so since we know that this downward means negative, but since we have shown it in the diagram, we have shown the downward arrow, do not put this negative sign. It has to be 10 only. But if we are considering, if we are finding, let's say, summation Fy, at that time in this equation you will have to consider to be negative. So there are two situations where we have to write forces. If we are representing them in diagram form, and if we are drawing the arrow correctly, no need to mention its sign. Yeah, so in this case we have fx, which is 10 cos 18.4349, and Fy, which comes out to be 10 sine 18.4349, which is 3.1623 newtons. Okay, so we get these two forces. Now we can find about point A. So first, let us say this force, due to this force, line of action of Fx is this, and I need a perpendicular distance from my moment center, that is at point A, to this line of action. So the perpendicular distance is this distance, correct? This distance will be perpendicular, no? So the moment at A will be, and the sine, because of this 9.4868, if I pin this point, this force will again be a clockwise force. It will be a clockwise rotation due to this force. Therefore, it is minus 9.4868 into 3. And along with this, this is also acting at point A. So its perpendicular distance, the line of action of this force is Fy, is this way, vertical. And the perpendicular distance is this. It is 9 meters, right? So 9 meters is the perpendicular distance. And how it is acting? How is it trying to rotate? See, if I keep this point as center, and if this force goes, it is going to go now anticlockwise. So this force is basically your positive. So plus 3.1623 into 9, you will get it 0. The reason that you are getting this as 0 is because if you see this slope of this force is 1:3, the slope of this frame member is also 1:3. See, it is vertically 3 and horizontally it is 9. So if I try to draw the slope, it will be 1 meter by 3 meters. That is basically a slope. So what you can say is that this 10 Newton was actually its line of action, was the one on which this point A was lying. And therefore, you finally got the moment to be 0. Because we learned that if the point lies on the line of action of that force, we are going to get the moment to be 0. MB is due to first force, 9.4868. Its perpendicular distance from point B is 3 meters. And if I consider this to be, if I pin this point and this force, if it tries to rotate keeping B as center, it will be rotating like this in a clockwise manner, correct? It is going to rotate in a clockwise manner. So it's negative minus 9.4868 into 3, and then we have this force 3.1623 keeping B as center, and its perpendicular distance is from B is basically 3 meters. So now let us understand what will be its sign convention. So keeping B as center, this force is again going to go clockwise. This force is again going to go clockwise. So it will be a negative one. So it will be minus 3.1623 into 3, which is equal to minus 37.9473 Newton meters. And since we got this answer as negative, it means it is a clockwise moment that is acting at this point B. So I hope you understood this thing. In the next lecture, we'll be seeing few more points about the moment. Till then, take care. Thank you.